You're welcome back to the Gavel. A lot of interesting activities occurred in the National Assembly during the week. Now let's take a look at some of them.
The chairman of the Senate Committee on Anti-Corruption, Senator Chukwuka Utazi, on Tuesday, December 11, presented a report on the confirmation of board members for the Economic and Financial Crimes Commission, EFCC. He's also to present a report for the confirmation of board members for the Independent Corrupt Practices and Other Related Offences Commission, ICPC.
The committee is satisfied that the nominees have the requisite experience, integrity, professional competence and industry to discharge the functions of the positions they were nominated into.
There are four nominees for the EFCC board, and they are from Kogi, Yobe, Kano and Oyo states. The ICPC has nine nominees, two each from the Southwest, Southeast, North Central and Northwest, and one from the South-South. But lawmakers from the South-South and the Southeastern part of the country were emphatically opposed to the nominations for the EFCC board.
The Southeast and the South-South are obviously not accommodated in the commission.
For us not to have anybody from the South-South, or from the Southeast in the NDD, in the EFCC, what does that portend? That these are the criminals. You are taking people from other geopolitical zones to, of course, come and investigate them. This is the picture that is being painted, and it is wrong.
Their position elicited contributions of lawmakers from other parts of the country to the debate.
As it is now, the law is not infringed upon. We are guided by the law. And I think only an amendment can cure it.
The chairman is from Southeast, and we are talking about shortchanging the Southeast. The chairman was there. He should have talked to you or the leadership. If they observed this, that would have been corrected, not necessarily coming here.
Senator Ndume's comments angered the committee chairman, who tried to offer an explanation.
I have something to say, Mr. President. I have something to say, Mr. President.
Sensing that the situation in the chamber may degenerate, the Senate President called for an impromptu executive session. After the executive session, the Senate President disclosed the decision of the upper chamber.
The Senate resolved to step down the consideration of the two reports for further legislative consultations on the nominees.
Another confirmation, which has practically been on hold for 1 year and 10 months, is that of EFCC Chairman Ibrahim Magu, who the Senate rejected in 2017, but is still the acting EFCC chairman. In the meantime, the confirmation of the board members of EFCC and ICPC remain inconclusive.
This investigative hearing.
Now moving to the House of Representatives. Officials of the Central Bank of Nigeria, the Nigeria Customs Service and other government agencies on December 11th appeared before a committee of a lower chamber. They are here for an investigative hearing into allegations of under-remittances of revenue to the Federation account. The representative of the Speaker of the House, who declared the event open, explained the need for the investigation.
The Federation Account Committee meeting in July was terminated two or three times due to controversies over unremitted revenue. This led to delays in the payment of salaries by the federal and state governments and other budgetary expenditure in most federal government agencies and establishments.
The central bank is the first to face the committee.
On the issue of undeclared revenue, we have never falsified reports. The revenue accounts of government, whether for federal inland revenues or for ANPC or DPRO, are owned by these agencies of government. Central bank statutorily is just a banker to government.
The committee was not satisfied with this position for the submissions of the other agencies present. A chairman of a committee highlighted what they expect going forward.
When we sell crude, the money comes in dollars to CBN, by JP Morgan account or whichever account. CBN converts this dollar to Naira. And we have documents to show that CBN takes 0.25% as commission for changing this money to Naira. So on Thursday, we want clarifications from you. Why, what is the essence of this 0.25% and what is the law backing it up? That is one. Two, the difference between the official exchange rate of 305 and 360 that CBN serves, what is the utilization of this difference, 55 naira for every dollar sold?
The agencies are expected to return on Thursday, December 20, to face the committee.
Of birth registration.
Meanwhile, lawmakers in the House of Representatives have kicked against the 4,500 naira being collected as birth registration charge. In a motion sponsored by Representative Nkiruka Oyejocha, the House expressed its concern that this charge may be working against the policy which seeks to encourage people to register births and deaths in Nigeria. The House is also encouraging the federal government to ensure sufficient funding of ministries, departments and agencies who carry out their mandates.
Make it compulsory for all births and deaths to be registered with the National Population Commission at no cost to citizens. The House is informed by a Daily Trust publication dated 26 October 2018 of the recent public-private partnership arrangement between the National Population Commission and Socket Works Limited, which has led to a 4,500 naira charge for processing birth registration. The House is worried that out of about 7 million children born yearly in Nigeria, 70%, that is 4,900 births, of these births are unregistered. And imposing charges for birth registration will further hinder indigent Nigerians from registering births with the National Population Commission.
The Senate has passed a bill seeking to establish a commission for the development of the southeastern part of the country. Now, the bill, called the Southeast Development Commission Bill, when signed into law, is expected to act as a catalyst to develop the commercial potentials of the Southeast and also address the environmental challenges of that part of the country. Now, the same bill had failed at third reading in the House of Representatives in 2017. Now, we had a chat with the sponsor of the bill, Senator Sam Anyanwu, to learn more about the bill.
I feel every senator from the Southeast, even our colleagues who are not from Southeast, feel very happy and excited that this bill has been finally passed into law. What it means is that the people of Southeast and other regions too, who intend to, you know, have this kind of commission, will have hope that it will pass through the cooperation and collaboration of our colleagues. So for me as an individual and as a sponsor of this bill, I feel excited that the bill which I single-handedly sponsored, my colleague, Senator Doe and others, have been passed into law. This is one of the bills, if signed into law, will be able to quell the nerves for people of the Southeast region. Since after the war, Southeast have gone through series of problem issues. It has to do with, you know, erosion, infrastructure degradation, you know, so many things, you know, which I wouldn't want to recap what happened during the war, which some of us did not experience, but have the story and seen it by ourselves, you know. But I think that what the major thing it will help is that in the Southeast is known to be in the economical hallmark, you know, of the nation, considering the Onitsha market, considering the Abia market, you know, today Nigerian goods has emanated from Aba. You know, you go to Onitsha, you have the innocent motors, assembly vehicles, motorcycles. So it's industrial of the country, and it will accommodate the entire nation, not just Southeast. Because if you go to Onitsha, Newe, you see people from the Yoruba land, southwest, people from the south, people from north, east, northwest. You know, because they are commercial centers of this country. So I think that with some of this bill, it will boost the infrastructure development of that area, especially the erosion menace. We just have to, you know, we have funds to be able, the commission will be able to do this, and also, again, create job opportunity. Because the chain value of this commission is enormous. Because both the agricultural sector, both the education sector, just like we have with the NDDC, as long as we have a good board and management that will handle that commission, people of service have no reason to complain, because a lot of funds will be channeled towards the infrastructure development of the place. I don't see any Nigerian, especially an elected member of the National Assembly, who would not want this to happen. So, and if this bill is one of the reasons that could bring peace, unity, faith, and progress in this country, I believe that will consider it. And besides, when this bill came on board, you know, because I gave it to my member of the House of Reps, who was presenting me in the House of Reps. But, you know, bills, no matter how beautiful that bill is, you must lobby your colleagues. You must let your colleagues to understand the important intent of such bill. It was not really properly canvassed. I know what it took me to canvass this with my colleagues. Even today that we're passing the last portion of the report, I had to start early in the morning to start lobbying my colleagues to let them see the sense in this bill.
Now, this is where we call it a day on this week's edition of The Gavel. If you have any views on any of the issues discussed, please email us on thegavel@channelstv.com. Thank you for staying with us, and see you again next week.